हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम राकेश चौहान वर्किंग एज पीजीटी फिजिक्स इन सूरज ग्रुप ऑफ स्कूल्स। आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन द ई लर्निंग क्लासेज ऑफ फिजिक्स। टूडे इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन द टॉपिक प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन। इन अवर लास्ट वीडियोज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन द डेरिवेटिव पार्ट ऑफ दैट टॉपिक। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू फोकस ऑन द न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम्स आस्क्ड ऑन दिस टॉपिक दैट इज प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन। So before going into the actual practice of these problems, first I would like to recall you the formulas which we have derived during the course of theory. Okay, so first we have discussed about angular projectile motion in our last videos. Angular projectile motion, and thereafter we have discussed about horizontal projectile motion. Horizontal projectile motion. So the formula which we have derived in angular projectile motion, the first formula was of the time taken to reach by the projectile or by the particle at maximum height. So time taken to reach at maximum height we have derived as u sin theta upon g, where u was the initial velocity of the projectile, theta was the angle making with the horizontal, and g is the acceleration due to gravity. Okay, thereafter we have derived the formula of maximum height, and maximum height was given as u square sin square theta upon 2g. That was the formula for maximum height which we have derived. And next we have derived the formula of flight time. It is denoted by capital T, and T was twice of th, means the time taken to reach at maximum height, if you multiply by 2 then it comes out to be flight time. So it is 2u sin theta upon g. And one more formula we have derived was range of the projectile. Range of the projectile, which was the maximum horizontal distance covered by the projectile, and it is denoted by r. And the formula we have derived was r is equals to u square sin twice theta upon g. And you must remember also that the condition for maximum range was theta is equals to 45. So if we have to write down the maximum range, then we will use u square upon g instead of u square sin 2 theta upon g, because if we put the value of theta is equal to 45 degree, then it becomes 1. So these four formulas we have derived during the course of angular projectile motion. Horizontal projectile motion, in horizontal projectile motion, the very first formula we have derived was of the flight time, we can say. So the flight time capital T was derived as twice h upon g, where h is the height from which the projectile is being projected in horizontal direction. So h was the height, g is gravity, and t is the flight time. Using the concept of this flight time, we have also derived the formula for range. And the formula for range was u into t. And in place of t, we can write down twice h upon g. One more formula which we have derived was the formula of velocity. So velocity, the magnitude of velocity at any time t was given by under root of vx square plus vy square. So in place of vx we have put here as u, and in place of vy it was gt, and we have derived these formulas. So I am just writing down the formula or result here. For detailed discussion, you can you know, once again watch these the previous videos of this chapter. Okay, this was the magnitude of that velocity, and if you want to find out the direction, then it was tan alpha Vy upon Vx. So with the help of this, we can find out the direction of velocity at any time t, and this, with the help of this formula, we can find out the magnitude of velocity at any point p or any time t, where u is initial velocity and g is the gravity. So these formulas we have derived in angular projectile motion and horizontal projectile motion. Now let us do some numerical problem on these formulas. Okay, so we are moving on to the first question on projectile motion. A football player kicks the ball at an angle of 30 degree. Means we have been given the angle theta with which the projectile or the ball is being projected with the horizontal. Okay, with an initial speed of 20 meter per second. So this is the initial speed. So whatever been given, we first mention it as the given parameters. So angle is given as 30 degree with the horizontal, initial speed is 20 meter per second, and we denote the initial speed by u. Assuming that the ball travels in vertical plane, suppose this is vertical plane and we have kicked the ball from here, so this ball will travel in this plane, not other than this plane. So this is to be assumed. Assuming that the ball travels in vertical plane, calculate the time at which the ball reaches at maximum height. Okay, so we have derived the formula of time taken by the projectile to reach at maximum height, and the formula is th is equals to u sine theta upon g. So this formula we have derived. We have been given u, that is 20, sine theta, that is sine 30, divided by g. You can take g as 10 for easy calculation. So it comes out to be 1 seconds, because sine 30 will be 1/2, and 1/2 will cancel out by this 2, and this is also 1, so it comes out to be 1 second. So in 1 second, the ball or football will reach at maximum height. Let us look on to the next question, which is the maximum height reached by the projectile. So the maximum height, we have derived the formula of maximum height. H max is equals to u square sine square theta upon twice g. So we have been given u, that is 20, so 20 square, sine square theta, that is sine 30 square, divided by g, 2g in fact, so this is twice of 10. So this comes out to be 400 multiplied by 1/4, because the value of sine 30 is 1/2 and square is 1/4, and this is 20. So 0 will cancel out by 0, this 4 will cancel out this 4, so it is 10 divided by 2, that is 5 meter. So this would be the answer of maximum height. Next, we have to find out the value of horizontal range. So horizontal range, what was the formula for horizontal range? You will say r is equals to u square sine 2 theta upon g. So u is given as 20, so 20 square, sine twice theta means 60 degree, divided by g, that is 10. So 400 multiplied by sine 60 degree, it is root 3/2 divided by 10, so it will cancel out, 20 root 3. This is the value of horizontal range. And one more part is the time for which the ball is in air, and you know that the time for which the ball is in air is known as flight time, and the formula for flight time is capital T is equal to twice of th, time taken to reach at maximum height, and it is 2u sine theta upon g. So 2 into 20 into sine 30, that is 1/2, divided by g that is 10. So 2 will cancel out by this 2, 0 will cancel out by this, so 2 seconds. So this is the flight time, which is just double of this time taken by the projectile to reach at maximum height. Okay, so we will do one more example, one more numerical. So the next question is, find the angle of projection at which maximum height and horizontal range are equal. This is horizontal range. So we have to find out the angle of projection with which, if a projectile is being projected, then the maximum height H max is exactly equal to the range, that is R. So we have been given that maximum height is equal to horizontal range according to the question or given situation. Maximum height is equal to the horizontal range. What is the formula for maximum height? You will say u square sine square theta upon twice g. And what is the formula for horizontal range? You will say u square sine 2 theta upon g. So by comparing these two equations, we have to find out the value of theta. So we will cancel out g by this g and u square by this u square. So it comes out to be sine square theta is equals to sine 2 theta upon 2, actually, because here 2 also. So sine square theta upon 2 can be written as, if we express this sine 2 theta in terms of sine theta and cos theta, so it will be 2 sine theta cos theta. Okay, we can write down this. So sine theta will cancel out the square, and in place of this 2, I can multiply this 2, and this cos theta will be divided by sine theta. So I can write down it as sine theta upon cos theta is equals to 4. And sine theta upon cos theta is 10 theta. So 10 theta comes out to be 4. So with the help of this, we can write down theta is equal to 10 inverse 4. And if you calculate the value of this 10 inverse 4, it comes out to be 75 degree approximately. So you need not to remember this value. You can write down your answer up to now or up to here. So this is your answer. 10 inverse 4. So this is how we can solve this question. This is quite simple question, in fact. So in our next video, we will discuss some more numerical problems. Thank you very much for watching this video.